University of Texas researchers are warning about the devastating impact the cactus moth could have on prickly pear cacti in Texas. They're worried the invasive insect will spread and destroy the cacti in Texas. Researchers say this could cause large-scale agricultural and ecological devastation in the state because many species rely on them.
In addition to the passion vine community work that I do, I've also become involved in studying invasive moths that have become established in Texas on prickly pear cactus. The prickly pear cactus is a really important resource for many species of animals, from birds that nest in it, like cactus wren, to a variety of native insects that use it as a host plant, to deer, to livestock and cattle use it to some degree as well. You see a lot of places where people have grazed really, really heavily, especially in the hill country. Cactus will replace a lot of what has been just mowed down by cattle, and you get then a forest of prickly pear cactus, which isn't any use to anything.
Many years ago, my father and my brother owned several bobcats, and they cleared this land, and we have cactus everywhere.
This is what happens when you totally clear cut it. It's not that the cactus is the problem. The cactus is taking advantage of a problem that was created by management that wasn't done in the best way. So this is Engelmann's prickly pear cactus. This is the most widely distributed species of cactus in North America. We're talking United States and Mexico. And this is a host plant for somewhere around 10 to 12 different species of native cactus moths, where the moth at night will come and she'll lay what's called an egg stick. Here's an egg stick, and this is probably about 50 eggs. Imagine a bunch of hockey puck shaped eggs that she'll find a spine, and she'll lay one, two, three, four, she'll lay them on top of each other, so it becomes a long curved stick that extends off of the spine, which is fascinating because if you don't know to look for this, it looks just like a spine. And then about a week or two later, the caterpillars will emerge from that egg stick, and then they will immediately start to burrow into the pad, or the cladode in scientific terminology. And from that point, those caterpillars are gonna feed on the tissue within the cactus pads for the rest of their lives. There's a lot of really cool biology for us to learn with respect to the natives, but also how the invasive cactus moth outcompete these natives because of its ability to reproduce and occupy areas such as this where there's a lot of cactus. A lot of the work that I do is comparative biology. We look at how does the native operate versus the invasive. You have to have points of reference with which to put context on the things you're seeing. The invasive cactus moth, it's well established from Port Arthur to Corpus Christi by this point along the coast, and it's moving inland quick. It's basically like a number of biological corridors with which the moths can go all the way to Canada, all the way to California, and all the way into the tropics. This cactus is a really important part of ecosystems because it creates a habitat structure for many different organisms, including tortoise out west, snakes, wood rats, deer mice, reptiles, and birds use the cactus as a structure. If cactus goes away from North America, it's going to likely cause ecosystems to begin to fall apart. This is a pretty pressing concern that we have at the invasive species lab at Brackenridge Field Lab with UT Austin. There's enough trees left, the oak and the cedar, that there's a source of other things to repopulate the area. So there's hope.